I have here two balloons. Now mine is Ignite healthy mucus-free balloon. Xand, I'm afraid yours is very badly infected, as you can see from the large amount of mucus in the airway. Ugh. Now let's inflate the balloons. 3, 2, 1.
This doesn't feel fair, Chris. My mucus-filled balloon is really hard to blow up.
You can see my balloon inflates extremely easily and also deflates extremely easily. How's it going, Xand?
Very badly. I've got a mouthful of mucus and I can barely get any air into this lung.
Seems to me, Xand, that you should have a bit of a cough.
Ooh, that'll make me feel much better.
OK, ready? 3, 2, 1. There we go.
When you cough, all the muscles around your chest and abdomen contract suddenly. This creates enough force to eject the mucus up your trachea and out of your mouth, like the mucus coming out of this balloon.
Now that has nicely cleared the mucus from Xand's airways, and now his lungs are clear again.
Oh, Xand, what have you been eating?
Well, farting is completely natural. It's just your body's way of getting rid of unwanted built-up gas. And everyone does it about 14 times a day. It doesn't matter if we're talking about your head teacher or the Queen herself. We all do it. And it's honestly not your fault.
He is actually right there. Inside your large intestines, there are millions of good bacteria that are there to help break down food.
And as they eat, they produce a mixture of gases, which is what makes you let rip.
This combination of gases is made up mainly of air, carbon dioxide, hydrogen sulfide, and methane. And the methane contains a lot of energy, as we're about to show you.
And for this, I'm going to need a special piece of equipment, Chris's hand. Now, this is a cylinder of methane, and I'm going to release one day's worth of farts.
This experiment is highly dangerous. We're in a controlled lab using specially manufactured gas. Don't even think about trying this yourself.
Get your hand wet. Now, scoop up those bubbles. That's right. Hold them well away from you.
I don't like the look of this. Ah! Xand, that was amazing. So that's how much energy there is in a day's worth of farts.
Exactly. That's one day's worth of farts.
Well, you know what we have to do now?
A week's worth.
Precisely.
1 week's worth of farts. That's really good, isn't it? So we've done a day.
We've done a week.
Dare we do a month?
Yes, we do. Dare. Do it.
Here we go.
Ice it.
Wow!
That was amazing.
Wow!
So we've shown you just how incredible your intestines are and how much energy there is in your farts. Remember, when you let rip, it's an essential part of how your body gets rid of excess gas.
And now you know whose fault it is that you do them in the first place, those cheeky little gut bacteria. But if they weren't in our intestines, we'd end up with undigested food sitting in there forever. So there really is no reason to be ashamed of your...
Now we've got an experiment where we're going to separate the water from the toxins in Chris's urine.
And then Chris is going to drink it.
What?
This may seem like a terrible idea, but Chris won't actually be drinking wee. He'll be drinking pure water extracted from it.
So as we heat the urine, the water vapour is evaporating and boiling off here and then being cooled by the liquid in this tube and then just dripping out there.
Right now, your kidneys are busy separating out water from waste toxins. Only they don't need all this kit, they just do it naturally.
It's amazing, isn't it? In just this tiny distance, you go from filthy, disgusting, undrinkable urine just along this tube and into clear, refreshing, delicious water. I mean, that is amazing, isn't it?
And if that was water your kidneys had separated out, it would now be distributed to all your organs and muscles to keep them working properly.
It doesn't smell like water.
Oh, no, it doesn't. You're still going to have to drink it, though. You told everyone you would.
I didn't say to anyone I was going to drink it.
Well, I'm not going to drink it. It's not my urine.
Fine, I will drink it.
I can't believe he drank it.
Actually, it smells bad, but it doesn't taste bad.
Which I'm very happy about.
Without water, your body simply wouldn't work. And you can help your kidneys do the best job they can just by drinking plenty of water every day.
If you're weeing regularly and it's light in colour, you'll know you're helping your body.
Remember, I've been on the healthy diet.
Ready?
Oh. Now, it does look like poo.
Certainly smells like poo.
Poo smells because of all the bacteria in your digestive system. As everything gets broken down, they release a lot of gas and smelly chemicals.
So it's less porridgey than it was on day one, but that's because I didn't drink enough water. There is something else interesting to see. Your body can't break down the fibre in food, like the shell on a piece of sweet corn. I've been eating a lot of sweet corn recently, so I can show you. If you have a look here, that is an undigested piece of sweet corn.